Hi everyone, you're watching JohnFX, and today as usual I'll make a little bit of overview what was happening during the day, my trading on this account, and also a little bit of setups for tomorrow. So actually guys, there were a lot of movements today. Just a moment, yesterday I released my video and did overview with setups and areas. The market actually moved quite a lot. So, we will have a look a little bit more at it at the end of the video, and when I will tell you what I'm looking for tomorrow. So, quite a lot of movements at night. That's why I actually didn't get too many trades, and on this account I had very little, only one trade really. So I'm going to show you account history. As you can see guys, pretty much I have pound dollar and actually euro Australian, which I had from the night where I showed you. It's only one trade I placed for the night and worked out well, profitable, and also euro pound. So guys, wanted to quickly to show you this. Something happened in euro pound, and remember I had a really nice pair was moving down when I was making the video yesterday, and I was in sell from the previous day. And you see this is what happened here. I think when the lot was going to split and the stop loss was supposed to move, it was actually, you see, the movement started to happen at midnight where they were changing the days, and so the spread was huge. And I think what happened here, it's at the same moment when the EA was trying to split the lot, move the stop, and the huge spread hit it. You see, that's why it hit me with a little loss. You can see the swap, and you see it's closed with minus 0.03 cents. So that was, I thought, that's really weird what happened. And actually it's reopened afterwards, a recovery trade with a smaller lot. You see it's calculated a smaller lot, and it was an opposite trade. So like recovery opened correctly as it's supposed to. But what I'm trying to say is that you see what can happen. That's why I don't like to have trades at night during the changing the days and also Asian session, because these things can happen. So you see, instead of catching a really nice, I was supposed to get a really nice move down, collecting the profit exactly where I was expecting it to, right from the yesterday video. So it's reached the level, and you see then afterwards it jumped out. So anyway, I had this trade closed manually in the morning when I saw that and there wasn't profit a little bit here, so I closed it because I was expecting that it wouldn't be a good movement. And you see exactly that's what happened. It jumped up and down, and so still stayed in the area. But my expectation of continuing the way down was exactly correct. So just wanted to point it out because you will see it in the video when I was actually doing it. So other than that, I had another profitable day. So you can see now guys, I have nothing floating here. And so let's see now into the day, how I got into other trades. We are looking right now at the morning of today's day, which is 28th of October, still was for me. And well, unfortunately, as you can see, the market moved at night, puts euro dollar, and already touched one of the levels. So that's why I had no possibility to get into the trades. I woke up a bit late also. You see, pound dollar did not consolidate in my area, even though it actually went there twice and only touched it and then reversed. So you see now I'm changing the levels just to see where it's going to go. So I'm preparing and thinking, what should I do next? Shall I jump into the trade or wait for it? So you see guys, because the movement already happened, I'm not jumping in. I'm waiting because it needs to a little bit balance or have a pullback or something else. You see, dollar Canadian also moved, and I had no chance to get in. The same, look at this, all these beautiful areas I had for a few days were broken. Pound yen had a really nice movement also at night, so I didn't catch the move. And also in the morning, it was already too late, so I'm not getting into anything. You see, pound euro pound was that strange trade, was continuing. Dollar yen pretty much continued the way down as I was expecting yesterday. So right now I'm just removing the levels, clear the screen, and I'm waiting for a bit of the movement. Australian dollar also started to move, already turned around. No chances to get in. The same with gold. As you can see, it's actually created a double top. I could have had a look at possible entry, but I thought it was a little bit late also, and I'm checking out other pairs. So this is Euro Australian, as you can see, the one which closed with profit. So it had a really nice movement and worked out quite well. So checking out at this moment if there are any other possibilities, what moved, or wherever I can get into other trades. So pretty much, as you can see, all the pairs had their moves. And so I'm just once again checking out if there is where the movements can go and what could be done, where it's going to be new levels, support levels, resistance for the other pairs, and it's just a bit of the waiting time. So what I'm trying to say is no jump in the movement, because it's already happened from the areas of expectation and already broke the level. So after it had a had the move, so now would be just waiting time to see when it started to consolidate. So you just, as you can see, dollar Swiss also unfortunately moved at night, already broke, where remember I canceled my orders, and now it's just once again to look through where it's going to go, because usually if it had a sharp move, it will have a pullback. So we don't want to, for example, buy now and then it's going to have a pullback to sit in floating, right? So we want to get maybe at the other retracement, the other pullback it makes, and then to get in. So that's why I'm placing the new levels and new highs to see where it can go. And that's pretty much it. No jumps into the trades at this moment, just checking out and analyzing what it's going to possibly do. So you see, doing for all the pairs. Once again, pound Swiss also had a move already, and pound Canadian actually had not a bad chance, but I quite ignored it. You see, pound Australian also moved as expected. Remember from the yesterday, it was possible to place a little trade, but yeah, it got into the side. And so you see, I was looking at possibilities now. It was creating a possible double top started, or breaking maybe support and continue the way down. So you see, I'm like looking and checking out. It's still an uptrend channel, but it was looking like going in a bit of a correction. But on the smaller time frames, looking like a possible could be double a bottom, but not created yet. So that's why it's all the waiting time. So you see, guys, I actually jumped into the pound because it had a pullback. As you can see, it gave me the wing and stuck still with the same level. So I have decided to just sell. And now you can see it's already split the half a lot and moved the stop loss behind. And now it's all goes on auto trading and moving the trailing stop behind it. So that's the only trade pretty much I had. And afterwards, as you can see, I closed euro pound, just as I explained to you a little bit earlier. I took a bit of the profit. And so you see, my point was is that the level I draw predicting possible that the pair should stop around this area and maybe start to consolidate. That's why I thought that, that buy stop, which happened last night, could not continue and might just sit in there for a while. So that's why I have decided just to take a small profit. And so pretty much that's it. Now let's see what we're going to do tomorrow. So starting with euro dollar, once again, I'm not planning to have any orders through the night, even though we had really good one last night movement. Now I'm looking into this little area. So because tomorrow is going to be news from ECB, European Central Bank, so I quite possibly can imagine that it might have a bit of consolidation before the news. So, but you can see now, guys, how much it's actually moving, just like I'm usually telling you on political events. We have election in America and also COVID-19, and more countries once again want to do restrictions, right? So, for example, Germany is thinking now to close the bars and restaurants for 1 month, so lockdown once again. So that's quite pretty much because of that. I can imagine that the euro possibly will continue the way down. So and we have a bit of a pullback now, but I still would like to see it a little bit of consolidating, and then I will be looking to place the order. So anything can happen, even though I think it should continue the way down. I don't know, maybe I will place the orders both directions. We will see, but maybe it will have, small consolidation, then it'll jump and give us a bit of like a pin bar or something, a little bit more glues, and then I quite possibly will just place one order for sale. But a little bit in here, it could be that we are in downtrend channel, right, in the big one, and that's what I think it should continue. It's actually jumped back inside the previous channel we had, right? So that's why it's all looking towards going down. But you never know, because it's a little bit of the uptrend, and then it can maybe, have some better news and might will have a little bit of a jump back up, maybe like a bit of a correction or something. So if you see from here, it might have a jump, it might go like 30 pips or even further. Something like 70 even pips. Well, depends to see what they're going to say. Maybe they will be talking about something which can make a euro to jump up, which I think it could be just a short term. If it will jump, it will be short term. That's why it might not be big movement, and then it will possibly continue the way down, because at this moment everything looks negative for euro dollar. So yeah, so that's the area and where I will be looking at placing new orders. Pound dollar, well, that's where I had a trade, right? So it's moved down, then it had some not bad news for pound about Brexit possible negotiation with the deal. You see, it's actually had a jump back exactly in the same place, but didn't jump inside and decided to sit outside under the level. So at this moment, technically, it's looking that maybe it'll have a bit of consolidation and continue the way down inside this channel, because we're still in uptrend channel, and at the same time we have a correction right inside the channel. So that's why it's more looking chances of continue the way down. But the news with Brexit can change completely the whole picture. So my point is, that's why I didn't highlight the areas, because if it will consolidate underneath this level, then I will be placing only pending order sell. So you see, guys, if it will sit here, so that's only or would be sell order, because if it will jump up, it might just touch this and then turn around, unless of course strong news. If it will go back inside this area once again, then I'm going to use that area and placing finally order buy stop, and from that level sell stop. So that's how I'm going to work with pound dollar. Dollar Canadian, well, had a huge move. If you saw oil actually fall, and I pretty much believe that's helped dollar Canadian to get stronger instead, well, dollar against Canadian dollar. So even though, like I told you last night, that I don't see it going all the way up at night. Yes, I had a little bit of this movement down, like giving us a little bit of bullish flag. But again, for me, it was a little bit too late. I didn't see this. You see, it's about 9 o'clock in the morning for me. It's actually 7 o'clock, and I'm still sleeping at that time. You see, guys, I'm missing quite a lot of good trades because they are happening during European opening of European session. And for me, as I'm in Europe, it's too early, and I can't make it. But I'm pointing you out at all of the series, so that's what you could do if you are in a good time zone. Then you can see what's happening before EU opens and London session. So about 7 o'clock a.m. European time, so about 7, 6, 7 in Europe. Well, possibly you can think it's like London time GMT, pretty much a GMT time around 6 a.m. 6, 7 GMT is quite good time to have a look. So that's why for me it's a little bit too early, and it's actually had a really nice and sharp movement. So what is it now? You see, didn't have a stop in the middle where I was hoping to get into the trade. One of the levels I have here, it looks like an uptrend channel. Of course, such a huge move, then it could have a pullback. Right now, also, I don't have an area here because it needs to give something, right? So you see from here, maybe it will give us a flag, a bullish flag, and then continue the way up again. Maybe it will just have a consolidation here and continue the way up. Or maybe it will have a bit of a correction first and stop somewhere in the middle or go back to the level. And right now, it's nothing obvious except looking like a little bit top, and so you see it might be double top, and that's why it might go down a little bit for correction. So that's why at this moment it's just a bit of a waiting time to see what's going to happen here. So hopefully nothing is going to happen again after I will release this video. And pound yen, also look at this beautiful area. I have been placing my orders, you saw guys, for so many times, had Monday and Tuesday, and finally again at night it's full. Like I told you, with yen pairs, Australia, New Zealand, yen, they all can move nicely at night. But like I told you, I'm a bit worried to do it because I'm not watching the screen. It's bigger spreads, slipperages, but I should have kept really the order here, but I didn't. Anyway, so you see, had a really, really nice move. So what is it now? I highlighted this area. It would be the next. It will consolidation. So you see, it might go back down again, give us a double bottom, and then turn around or consolidate, and then actually continue to have a bit of a correction, right? Because I had a really good drop, and maybe it will have a correction. But we found Brexit news, right? Right now, we're still in uptrend channel. So technically looking, it should continue the way up. That's why either waiting from the series go up or give us maybe double bottom and then go up. Maybe it will stuck a little bit in the area, who knows, and then turn around. So, but at this moment, we are just waiting. At the same time, we have a little bit of the low, right? One top is higher, another one is a little bit lower, and the same at the bottom. So it might be the first signs of turning around, okay? So, but I'm not drawing this at this at moment anything. It's a bit too five, and that will jump up. It still needs to go through at least this level before we'll consider that it is possible a little bit of a turning around. So just waiting for that area. Euro pound, so you see, it's pretty much I was expecting. You saw me drawing this level today, actually still today, during the day. That's why I had closed the buy order, which was open strange way last night. So it didn't consolidate. That's it, had really those jumps up and downs. And at this moment, with euro pound, I'm rather still once again to see it go into this area for consolidation, and then possible either continue the way up or go down. But it's getting very, very narrow into this area. I mean, of course, the best would be if it will go a bit more narrowing, and then we will see. But I mean, I don't like at this moment. You see how wings, it went up and down and back again. So it's a lot of uncertainty happening right now in here, because pretty much it's waiting for some Brexit news at the same time. Well, tomorrow, that's why it could possibly be some movements because of the ECB might say something. So that's why, I mean, it's getting very narrow, and pretty much it could be a big move one or another direction. I mean, right now it's still looking like a huge wedge. Bullish wedge, so it might have a huge move. So for that, it has to be the news, right? So who has to be good news for euro and not very good for pound to make this big move. But I think it's going to be a really nice and big move when it jump up from here. So at this moment, I don't really like anything. Let's see how it will prepare, where it's going to be before the news. Okay, now we're going to dollar yen. Dollar yen, you see, it's touched. It's again at the quite important area, right? Again at the same bottom. We had few times we've been here, and I don't know, maybe this time it wants to break through actually eventually and go more further down. So that's why I'm not jumping into buys from here, even though, yeah, it's moved down for quite a while, and previously it's been jumping from that level. But you know, this time, who knows? I mean, it kind of like looks a little bit like that previous one, right? So we have the same kind of looking, a little bit smaller, that had this little like a little shoulder head, and about a little shoulder, it also has a little bit shoulder head. Well, let's see if it's going to create us another shoulder, or it might give us some continuum, well, maybe a little bit correction, and then still we'll try to break this level. Well, there will be some news for Yen, I think, at night. Once again, I will not be able to see and watch it, so I'm not going to place the orders. Maybe there will be some movements and there will be some clues tomorrow, but this moment I'm just going to leave it. I'm not highlighting the area because it's a little bit wide, so that's why. Let's see, maybe it will go back at night or break a little bit and see what's going to be next. At this moment, just a waiting time. Australian actually eventually had a good move from this also. Consolidation didn't go higher where I was hoping it will go higher. That was my possible entry point in here, but unfortunately it didn't give me any opportunities, so it's full. And right now I'm just waiting for this to come down and get somewhere, because it's not in a nice position at this moment for me to get into any possible trades. You see, we have that bottom again, so maybe it will get a little bit more here. Maybe it will give me a little bit of the bearish flag again, and then I would be looking at some possibilities. At this moment, it's just nothing. So gold, well, fall again. Had this, you see, guys, why I didn't want to go. When I went in the morning, it was already somewhere around here. So you see, the good possible entry point was around this level. When I started, it actually gave a little bit of the double top. But it was so short for this level. That's why I thought if it's a double top and I was already here, it was just a little bit of movement and I just felt I wouldn't risk it. So the good entry was around this area. But you see, it's actually had a huge move, which I was telling you that I was looking into such a big move because it's been sitting here for a while and finally it's broke. And also that I was telling you last night, with all the stimulus they were talking about, that they have a delay until the election now, I was expecting gold to fall anyway, but didn't place the orders once again. So what is it now? To be honest, with the all the kind of news, I would presume it continue the way down, at least to the next bottom. It has more here, like another, well, kind of pretty much broke this bottom a little bit. And it might try to climb again up. But you see, if they were saying it was reacting on stimulus, then right now we do know they're not going to happen. So that's why pretty much gold should continue the way down. But there is also the situation with COVID. And this might be another thing to make gold to go back up. So that's why, I mean, it's in a nice area and nice position right now. Here, that's why I think if it will have a bit of consolidation, I will be placing the orders possibly both directions. So once again, let's see, maybe it will give us a double bottom here or like another wing or something. And but if it will have just a bit of consolidation, then I will be looking. It's a little bit wide right now, so it's about 100 pips, so maybe it will give a triangle or something. That's the area to look at, yeah, because from here it's definitely should have the movement either direction. You see, it's like why I think it's going to be stopping here, because it's pretty much like quite empty, and like I don't know why would it continue the way down. I mean, it might have that big huge move, but it's well, I don't know, we will see. It's just talking a little bit further. I don't think it can happen straight away. Except gold can do things like that, right? So it can. I mean, right now it needs a little bit of correction, I would say, which also for gold it doesn't necessarily can happen. So that's why I just wait this area and then we'll see. So because I think if it will go down, that's the previous bottoms, it might have tried to break it a little bit and then come back. And because right now it's not giving me anything. I mean, okay, it has a little bit of pin, but it's not not very nice one. And you see on a smaller on 1 hour, it's more, it's not looking anything at this moment. I mean, I just, that's why I prefer just to wait and see. Okay, so that's pretty much it. You see New Zealand dollar, right? It was a good, when that's when I had on 1 hour chart, you see when I had these little pins. They helped me to stop. But it, look, it's created double top. So again, that would have been an entry point for double top, a little bit below, of course. But I didn't go for it again. It was too late for me. And now it's broke. Looks like maybe double bottom creating. And from here, it might would try to turn around again. But I don't know. At this moment, I wouldn't get into it because it might just finish the movement. Of course, if it would finish the movement, then this would be a nice area to look at. Okay, so, but at this moment, I'm just not going to do anything with this pair. I'll just wait for it. Euro pairs, of course, I will be looking at tomorrow, see where they're going to consolidate because of the CB. So that's why for Euro Australian, that's the area. If it will consolidate here, very good. As Euro Australian, quite volatile. That's why I'm looking at it's going to have a really nice, you know, distance to go up and the same go down. It, you see, that's where it had really nice move. And you see how sharp it's actually turned around. Didn't have any consolidations, just jumped back up. Euro-Canadian, possibly also we will see where this will go. Maybe I will have a look at also placing the orders. It started to have maybe giving a double top. I don't know, so that's the area. Also, not that bad. I mean, it has about 70 pips to go up and quite a few, like 40, 50 pips to go down. So if it will sit in here, except Euro-Canadian might not be as good because Canadian is a little bit weak. But we will see. Euro-New Zealand also, you see, that's the area I will be looking at possible placing new orders before the news. And Euro-Yen, pretty much you see how expected it stopped at one of the levels. Let's see for some consolidation. Right now, just I don't even like this too much. Also, there will be news for yen. So let's see, maybe it will give us a double bottom. And we'll try to go up inside this channel. But I'm not going to do anything right now. New Zealand yen also looking like a little bit of possible creation double bottom. But not looking into it right now. Also, dollar, Swiss. Well, is it because it's already broke and the level and moved and I didn't get into the trade right now, I will just see where that movement would go. Of course, I would rather to prefer it to have a pullback down. So, and if it will go down, it will not break inside again this area, maybe. So then it would be possibility, maybe it will continue the way up and I will see it possible entry points. But at this moment, I'm just not going to do anything with it. Pound. Canadian, so also maybe we'll look at this area and pound might continue the way up just because Canadian is a bit weak, but Brexit news, so if it will have a nice consolidation here, maybe it will be double, at this moment looks like double top, but like I'm saying, a bit worried about because Canadian dollar, but anyway, so that's the area to look at. Pound Australian, also looking like a bit of, maybe it will be double top. Maybe head and shoulders, who knows, but that's also the area possibly to look at. So pound Swiss, I don't really like it as much how it moves, also has a lot of wings. Maybe also this area, but not sure, I don't really like it as much, so I'll just have it here and then we will see. I think it's pretty much it. Canadian Swiss I also just here, but not doing anything with it. So that's pretty much it, my view guys, on the market for tomorrow and my day trading today. Let's hope tomorrow is going to be more trades, and happy trading everyone. I see you in my next video. Bye.